Esteemed sisters and brother judges, learned advocate general, president AP High Court Bar Association, chairman Bar Council of Andhra Pradesh, additional advocates general, assistant solicitor general of India, public prosecutor, law officers, learned senior advocates and members of the bar, officers of the registry, family members of late Honorable C. Justice P. Kesava Rao, ladies and gentlemen. We have virtually assembled to mourn the sad demise of Honorable C. Justice P. Kesava Rao, sitting judge of the High Court for the state of Telangana, who left us for the heavenly abode on 9/8/2021 in the wee hours at 3:47 a.m. The news of his lordship's death caused shock and deep sense of irreparable loss, not just to the members of the family, but to the entire legal fraternity. Honorable Justice P. Kesava Rao was born on 29th of March 1961 to Sri Potlapalli Prakasa Rao and Srimati Jayaprada. He was married to Srimati Usha. He has two sons. His lordship graduated from Kakatiya University in 1986 and enrolled as an advocate in 1986. He initially joined in the office of late Sri Pingal Sabasiva Rao in Warangal district and later in the office of late Sri M. V. Ramana Reddy in Hyderabad in 1991. His lordship started independent practice in 1996 in various branches of law and represented the United States of Andhra Pradesh as a government pleader, attached to the office of Sri B. Prakasa Reddy, the then additional advocate general from October 1998 to October 2001. His lordship was the special standing counsel for CBI from 2010 to 2016 and even later on special engagement. His lordship was the standing counsel for the Greater Hyderabad Municipal Corporation from 2015 till elevation to the bench. His lordship was sworn in as a judge of the High Court of Judicature for the state of Telangana and the state of Andhra Pradesh on 21/9/2017. I was not fortunate enough to meet his lordship, but I am told by my esteemed colleagues in the bench that he had a very pleasing personality and was respected by all for his simplicity and down-to-earth nature. I, on my personal behalf, and on behalf of my sister and brother judges, convey our deep condolences to the members of the bereaved family. We pay our respectful homage to the departed soul and pray to Almighty that his soul may rest in eternal peace and to bestow strength to the members of the bereaved family to bear the irreparable loss.
My Lords, the Honorable the Chief Justice, Honorable Judges, Senior Counsel, Assistant Solicitor General, Chairman Bar Council, Government Law Officers, President Bar Association, and lawyer community. It is indeed sad that Justice Keshav Rao is no more. He has been having a rough time in the last 1.5 years, and true to his personality, he manfully came through all the instances of pain and was ready for work and was at work until recently. He and I have not worked together in any matters, but he was a part of one of the most respected senior counsel when I joined the bar in 1992, and that was in the office of Mr. M.B. Ramanareddy, senior counsel. And a few colleagues of mine who had enrolled along with me happened to join that office, including one Mr. Vivekanand. And all of us used to hang around, and we used to fondly call Justice Keshav Rao Keshav Anna. He had a brilliant practice and footing in civil law while being in his hometown. And he would hold himself against all the senior counsel who were stalwarts in the United Court at the earliest point in time. That he had the talent and flair for all laws, including the public law, which he evidenced during his stint as special government leader in the office of Mr. Prakash Reddy. And then he showed his prowess in the criminal law while serving as standing counsel for CBI during one of the most difficult times. And my colleague Niranjan Reddy and I would have to face him every day in a set of matters at that point in time. He was tough but fair, combative but reasonable. At the end of the conversation and at the end of the debate, all of us would join for a cup of coffee. He was quintessentially the public prosecutor of the copybook, the textbook style. After that, he had also held a couple of public positions as standing counsel for GHMC, and we have had to appear against each other in a few matters. And he was also a powerful votary of certain beliefs in relation to the events which overtook all of us during the course of agitation. He held strong views, but at the end of the day, all of us had been treated to a very compassionate sense of comradeship, because at the heart of it all, he was a lawyer par excellence, a professional committed to the nice things in the profession, and I think most of it all, a person who will find an opportunity to smile in the wake of all adversity. He is a neighbor to a former colleague of mine in Hyderabad. And when I had visited there during the course of last visit to Hyderabad, I was informed that he had stopped work and he is under care. That he had to leave so early is perhaps part of the folklore that divinity wants a little of human content to maintain its divinity early in life. Here goes another man who strove all through to impart to every office he held the aura that enhances the majesty of every office he held. A proud father of two children, the eldest of one employed in America, being an engineering graduate, and the younger one having just completed law from Jindal and who was to set foot into the profession, and he's not there for us. For all of us, he remained Keshav Anna all through, and including after his elevation, he would insist that we call him Keshav Anna. He is no more, and people of his ilk are in a hurry to leave us. We can't control that, but we would be enriched by the continuing memories, and here is hoping Keshav Anna is watching over all of us to nudge us back to being the fair, the tough, the combative, and the reasonable lawyers that all of us can be, irrespective of whichever divide we pursue. God bless you, Keshav Anna. You have blessed us in plenty in the toughest of times. You are one of the fond remembrances that we have of the tough times that was between 2001 to 2014. God bless you. God bless your family with all the fortitude and the grit to survive your absence. You have always found us wanting for words when you were opposing us in court. Here again you find us. Here is wishing the family all the godly support to survive this. On behalf of the fraternity, I pray Almighty bestow upon the family all the goodness that Keshavana had spread around him and the composure to overcome his loss. May his lordship attain his sadgati in the world of his own.
Lordship's Honorable Chief Justice and the respected judges of this Honorable Court, the Learned Advocate General, the Chairman Bar Council, the Public Prosecutor, the Assistant Solicitor General, the family members of the Justice P.K. Sorao, the law officers of the state, the senior advocates and other colleague advocates and the other staff of the High Court. We are assembled here with a deep sense of sorrow to pay homage to Justice P. Keshav Rao, the sitting judge of High Court for the state of Telangana, who suddenly passed away on 9th August 2021. The sudden demise of Justice P. Keshav Rao, he left us in deep sorrow, and the same is lost to the institution also. His sound contribution to the judiciary is countless and everlasting. His Lordship is a judge with greatest commitment, integrity, and patience, and always courteous to the bar. It is hard to digest his departure from this world. Justice P. Keshav Rao born on 29th March 1961, and he is the first generation advocate in his family. His Lordship enrolled as an advocate in the year 1986 and initially started his practice in District Courts Warangal. Thereafter, in the year 1991, he shifted to Hyderabad and joined in the chambers of late M.V. Ramana Reddy, senior advocate. As an advocate, His Lordship was a versatile lawyer and dealt with variety of cases. For a long time, he worked as a special standing counsel for CBI, continued in the said position till he was elevated on 21st September 2017. As an advocate, he was my contemporary in the profession and also innate friend of mine. We argued together several matters. He was a tough opponent for me in so many matters. His sudden demise due to ill health is an unfilled gap to the judiciary and also to advocates fraternity. He left behind him a legacy of qualities of great jurist. During his tenure as a judge, he delivered several landmark judgments touching upon wide range of issues, including the civil criminal service, constitutional issues, etc. His knowledge of all branches of law and his intellectual exposition of principles of law, as well as his strong views in the administration of justice, in his judgments and orders, I express and place on record my deep sense of gratitude for His Lordship's contribution and also to the bar. Is exemplary, and his sudden demise is a great loss to the judiciary and also to the advocates fraternity. All that remains now is the memory of what he did as a judge of the High Court of Andhra Pradesh, High Court of Telangana, and also to the composite High Court. On behalf of myself and also on behalf of the advocates fraternity, I extend my deepest condolences to the bereaved family of His Lordship's members and pray the Almighty to give strength to them to bear this unfilled loss. I pray Almighty to rest his soul in peace.
something of this with him. There should be 1 minute silence. What is it? Court work for the remaining day shall remain suspended.